convinced I got annihilated with mosquitoes. Mosquitoes.
That's my TV. Alright, so on this episode of Retro Wednesdays, we are taking a look at Little Nemo, the Dream Master. I don't know very much about this game other than Capcom's, and I used to rent it all the time from West Coast Video, and I could never get very far.
Really? You rented this game?
Yeah. I rented a lot of weird games. I rented Pirates, this game all the time, the second Ninja Turtles game.
That's a good one.
Gunsmoke.
That's a good one.
And I forget what else, but this one was in heavy rotation for rentals because I always wanted to beat it and I never get very far.
Well,
do you have any moves or any...
I never played this game as a kid. I know it's inexpensive.
Yeah.
Well, maybe it's more. Back when I was still actively collecting stuff, this was like $4.
It's like $50 now, guaranteed.
Shut up.
I bet it is. I'm going to be surprised.
Okay. But I did notice, just from watching the demo, that it has the same... It must have the same composer as, like, Street Fighter 2010, because it's got that same sort of style. And I know that they share sounds, but anyway.
Yeah.
So, you want to start it up?
Yeah, I guess I'll give it a swing. So, the premise of the game is you're some dude who gets sucked into Dreamland, and you can turn into different animals and such by giving them candy. I never got very far in this game at all. It's kind of creepy. What are you doing here?
It says little boys too many times in this.
They'll give you a ride if you give them candy. Is this like some pedo bear game or something? Okay. Alright, flip. Can I give you candy? Oh, you left. I always thought like he had something on his back, like a weapon, and I can never figure out how to use it.
Is that a backpack?
At first I thought that, but I think it's just a bag for his candy, maybe? So you can feed certain characters in the game, like he mentioned. And now I'm a frog dude, so I can jump way higher.
And you can also
swim. I can belly bomb enemies. But you're slow as shit.
I think one of the things about this game that it's not clear right now because you've played it before, but it's not... It doesn't make it very apparent what needs to be done in a situation.
Yes.
For instance, I see a yellow belly of a frog. I think that's got to be the weak spot.
Right.
And then you can jump on the spike turtles. That just doesn't seem... Doesn't make sense.
What? How did that hurt me?
And the other thing was... figuring out how to become one of the animals was...
Yeah, it took a while for me to figure that out, too.
The goal of the level is to get all the keys.
Yes. Sometimes you can, like... jump on the dudes that'll help you, and sometimes you can't. I don't know. I saw this part in the demo, so I'm kind of cheating. What? Okay. Fucking hit detection's terrible. I love that frog. Like, I didn't know this was a good guy forever. So now I can dig. Through the ground.
You look really weird.
But I can't jump.
You look too...
So pink. I don't know... Yeah. I never figured out how you're supposed to get past that part, because now I'm stuck. I have to do this.
You can't do
that. I mean, I guess I could get out. No, you can't jump when you're the mole. Like, this part's a cool concept, but it's just really annoying.
Well, I think they did something that's important.
Yeah.
They showed you how to use this in a you know, beginning area, and they focused on that you couldn't jump, which is, I think, good.
Man, wasn't there the bro? Now I'm gonna get hit. Haha. Come on, man, that is cheap. Do I keep all my keys or do I have to start over? Alright, now I'm good.
Sounds like the DuckTale sound.
What the hell? Yeah, I think like the same general composer did all the music for like the kids. I don't know. Here we go. This is a kids game, but I think it's more kid oriented. It's not, you know, it's a light subject matter. And the jumps don't even work. Ah, I'm one fucking key short. Have some candy. I don't know where the other key is. Fuck, now I'm just getting my ass kicked.
It's gotta be up above.
Let's do this. I'm gonna score.
Is that a key?
Let me look. Nope, just health. It's not there. This is the part that sucks, is like the infinite respawn enemies and the fact that my character has no attack. What the fuck, man? So, I don't know about you, but maybe this is my inner fat ass talking, but candy was always a big part of my life growing up. Because candy's awesome. And I'm also biased because I had not one but two relatives actually work in a candy shop.
Do you?
Yeah, so my grandma used to work on at the James Saltwater Taffy thing on the boardwalk.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, so she used to bring me candy all the time. That's where she met Mike Tyson. Because he came in and bought, like, $150 worth of fruit slices.
Those are good.
They are. And I got really mad at my grandma because, she wouldn't... He was like, do you want to... Like, he was talking to her, and he's like, I guess at some point he brought it up and he just asked her, like, do you know that I'm, like, a boxer or whatever? He's like, do you want an autograph or something? Because it could be worth money. And she was like, no. Because she said his hands are lethal weapons and it made her nervous. I was like, why would you do that?
What?
I got upset because I was like, oh, my God, you'd be so rich. I was a little kid, so, like, something that was worth, like, $100 would have been, like, a dream come true.
I think it would be cool to have his autograph still.
That is so cheap. Come on, what the fuck?
So what about candy?
So what are some of your favorite candies? Or were favorite candies growing up?
I really, really, really like Snickers with almonds, which used to be called Mars Bars.
Yeah.
And now they don't make them anymore. And I always loved... I like almonds and stuff, so...
Yeah.
I like those. I like Mounds. Or not Mounds. Almond Joy. And almond M&Ms.
All right.
Those are my favorites.
Whoa.
Oh, and Charleston Chews.
Okay. I like Mary Jane's.
Those are good.
And you know what my all-time favorite is? As sad as it is, and everyone always makes fun of me for it? Fruit slices.
Those are good. I didn't know they were your favorite, though.
They're pretty up there. I don't know if they're, like, absolute top-tier... Like, God's your favorite, but they're definitely up there. Come back here, I want to be a gorilla. So now I'm Donkey Kong. That's kind of cool.
It's Gorilla Kong.
I'm slow as shit. That's the only problem. But I can throw punches. Eat it.
You can just climb, too?
Yeah. So the gorilla's a good character to have. Is this something? Let's find out. Nope. God damn it.
I think my impression of this game is pretty much It has all the workings of a really good game, but it just doesn't pull it off.
Yeah.
It's just got really good graphics, the music's pretty good, but it's just something about it is just not that great.
I like the premise of it, I mean, even though it pretty much blatantly steals from Kid Chameleon.
Well, I would imagine that this came first.
Did it? I don't remember when this came out. I don't know, I think Kid Chameleon came out first. Oh, really? Wow, man, I just got fucking shit on.
Kid Chameleon's a great game.
It is a good game. We should do that. No, sorry. I only got us to, like, second fucking level.
Already sweaty.
Yeah, already barking in here. I think you do get infinite continues, which is kind of nice. Which also indicates that they knew that this game was fucking outrageous hard.
I want to know what the Japanese version of this game is.
Wanpaku Sleepo Graffiti. I think part of the problem is that when you're just Nemo, you're so useless that it's almost too much.
I think that's cool, though, because then they force you to...
Yeah, they do, but I mean, at the same time, like, I shouldn't have to, like, go all out to just jump over an enemy. And I shouldn't get hit on those, like, haggard-ass angles because I can't control my character. There's supposed to be another character you can get later that can go in there.
Probably that squirrely thing.
Whatever. Yeah.
I see what they did.
Come on! I'm getting so aggravated. Where the fuck did that guy come from? Oh, what the fuck, man? It's not perpetual?
That is messed up.
Fucking so haggard. How are you supposed to know that? Where's the dialogue box that explains... Oh, you motherfucker. That explains that to you. Well, I got the two keys at least.
Do you think if, games...
Dude!
In this time period had the storage capacity to do tutorials, they'd do them?
No. Because they didn't care. Because back in the day it was, fuck you. You already bought the game, what do I care if you have fun with it?
Actually, it seems to me that back then there was no recognition of the company who published or developed the game. I didn't pay attention to it.
Yeah, it's true.
But now I do.
Oh my god, dude. Hit detection is making me cranky.
It's also fucking hot.
God. Alright, dude, what the fuck? Now I'm getting aggravated. Games should not be this ridiculous in the second level.
We're already in...
How many levels are in this game?
I don't know. Let me find out.
You should look it up.
I think this game would be really, really much better if... I think you're right, though, about the character not completely being useless.
Yeah.
Because it's not satisfying to use this guy.
Well, there's just no advantage to it. You're just at a perpetual disadvantage until you get something to help you out.
In my opinion, it's important to have a satisfying thing so that the gameplay is satisfying.
I also truly, truly hate the automatic respawns.
They are ruthless with it.
And how every character has... Every enemy, always has some kind of move to get back at you. So, I was reading... We're looking up a guide on GameFAQs. And I was looking at the guide, and it tells you that the trick is with the floater enemies is to let them lock onto you and then fall straight down, and then you can dodge out of the way. And then you get,
How do you fall straight down?
They lock onto you. See how that one just did that? Where it floats down and it locks onto where you're at?
Yeah, but how do I fall straight down?
So you don't fall straight down. The enemy falls straight down. You move left or right.
How can I do that on here, though?
You're not... get off the trunk, is what I'm saying. So you know, say you did that, and then you get up. You got to go... You had a chance to go up.
Whoa, buddy.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God, dude. But once you're on the purple guy, it's way easier because you're way faster. The gorilla is the hard part because you're fucking slow as shit.
Shit, gorilla.
Yeah. I like how the lizard looks so happy. Alright, you should practice to see how high you can jump. Oh my god, dude!
I wasn't paying attention for 1 second.
We got 5 keys, and we're 1 short.
Son of a bitch.
Can you go up the tree?
Maybe.
Oh my god. It's fucking nerve-wracking. No.
I'm an idiot. What am I doing?
You can go in the water. Oh, you can't. I thought you could.
What the fuck is this?
Fucking psycho rabbit. Wait, keep going left. There was a water puddle. I think it was this one. Try going down in here. Because you didn't go this way last time. That's probably... Oh, I was going to say.
That would be hilarious if it killed me.
I don't know what that is. There we go. Well, we got the last key. Now you just gotta survive this bullshit. One hit.
Yo! Worm's coming.
Yep. Oh my god, every muscle in my body clenched up for that one.
Yeah.
All right, 25% of the way through this game.
I feel like we just need to get the idea of like we need to pick up what they're putting down.
Yeah.
So they.
Nemo, why are you?
They tell you what to do. You just need to find it.
Yeah, you just need to figure it out.
Now some toys.
Toys. What game were we playing when that happened?
I have no idea.
I remember Super R-Type.
Super R-Type?
Yeah, the R-Type for Super Nintendo.
I don't remember that at all.
That was it. I remember I had that tape recorder thing and I was recording the soundtrack.
I wonder if you... Could you find that tape?
I'm sure I have it. If I don't have it, my mom has it. She never threw anything out that I've ever done in my life. Come on, man. That is such shit. What am I supposed to do?
We actually recorded our own radio show.
Yeah, that was like the premise for what we're doing now. If you think about it, man, we were so far ahead of the idea of YouTube, it wasn't even funny.
Yeah, right.
We should have cashed in on it.
Yeah, why didn't we make it?
Up. I mean, we blew it.
I saw they launched Pokemon Go just this
week.
Oh
my god, yeah.
And you know that feeling you get when you missed out on something? Where you're like, damn it, I should have thought of this.
Yeah.
Have you tried it?
I have not, but I'm very... I'm honestly interested in it.
I am not interested in it. I tried it, and I asked... Like, I asked my wife. I was like, alright, so... What's the point? The
game? Shit!
She's like, oh, you capture the animals. I was like, okay. You capture a Pokemon, now what? And they're like, you can level it up. I was like, okay. What's the object of the game? And no one can give me an answer. And they're like, I was like, can you battle? Like, yeah, if you go to the gym, you can battle.
Yeah, I think the goal is to take over the gym or gyms that are closest to you. So you can be like local hero or whatever.
Did you play Pokemon when it was...
Honestly, no. It was like one of the game franchises I just... Oh my god, dude. Those bombs are so cheap.
Fuck.
Though, Yeah, it was just one of those game franchises that I just never got into. This part is like just straight memorization to get through it. Dude, what the hell?
I gotta stop drinking this Rockstar or else I'm gonna be up all night.
I was up super late last night. Playing fucking Destiny. Oh, no one plays that game anymore. People still play that game? Taken King, more like Taken Wallet. So fucking lame. It's a fun game.
You know, I saw something. Like an article that said that Little Big Planet is shutting its servers down because it's an old game.
Yeah.
And it made me think, you know, the way that a game is marketed nowadays, it's almost like a fleeting game, you know?
Yeah.
Because once the servers go down, you can't play it, can you?
I don't think so. Did you see the PlanetSide server shut down? Did you see the shutdown that they did?
No.
It was actually pretty awesome. So they shut the game down, and to end it, they create the game developers created this huge meteor shower that killed all the characters in the server. Like, it was like the end of the planet. The planet was dying, and that was like the extinction level event, as nerds scientists say.
That's actually pretty cool. I didn't hear that.
Yeah, it was pretty. I mean, I don't know. I thought it was pretty cool.
So PlanetSide's no more.
Yeah, the first one. The other one, PlanetSide 2, is still going strong.
I played the first one. I remember that.
Cut! Whoa! I was about to get real upset. I'm not going to question it. I'll just take it. I didn't get the extra life, but whatever.
I hear sound effects from all different games from Capcom.
I know.
This sounds exactly like Bionic Commando.
It does. God fucking damn it. I just hate how this level just throws so much shit at you. It's like, I never know what to expect. I mean, what am I supposed to do? I have to get those keys.
They're gonna be Whoa.
Oh my god! Ah, well, now at least you see what you gotta do.
Oh, no.
I'm like the setup man, you're the closer. I took a train like that from Philly to Baltimore, and it was awesome.
I recommend it. I mean, I was coming from New Jersey, so it sort of wasn't as convenient, but if I was coming out of Philly, for instance,
yeah,
it would be very convenient. And it wasn't expensive. And you don't have to go through, you know, you don't have to go through the TSA.
Yeah. No shit, Sherlock. Thanks. Thanks for explaining the game mechanic to me four levels in. Brilliant. Ooh. Looks like... Eat the candy! Ew. It's a snot bubble. Can you go down into the sand?
Yeah.
Like that, I bet. Yeah, look at that, buddy! I'm starting to think like this game. Damn it. It is fucking hot in here. Woo. Woo woo.
Maybe we ought to do it here only in the winter. Make sure there's not a goddamn key in the first part.
I already got that one key.
I mean, like, underneath. They would pull a move like that in this game.
Yeah. Yeah, I didn't see it. Come on! Wow, thanks. Like guessing here.
Can you drown?
No, I don't think so. At least. Whoa!
Who was that?
This is fucking Dick Needle, Dick Nose, and that fucking guy is still following me. Wow, man, what the fuck? Frustrating. Whoa, where am I?
Spawn? McGee? Oh.
Oh, that's where I'm at.
Wait a minute, why would it... I thought it spawns you at the beginning.
Yeah, I guess this time it didn't.
It's got a weird face.
Game's getting nuts. Fuck! Come on, man! Fucking frustrated. I don't know why I'm so frustrated because it's so hot in here, that's why. It's the only reason. These fucking sperm shit monsters keep chasing me. Fuck! so aggravating. All right, well, I don't have to do that part anymore.
Fuck!
Oh, you motherfucker!
Does he have no attack?
Of course not. He's got this big ass meat hook hands and can't do anything with him.
He's got giant boxer gloves on.
You know what's good about this guy, though? You can stop.
You can also get attacked by these... I don't even know what they are.
Shit whores!
Damn.
God damn it! Beasts.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
Nailed it. I hate those fish, man. If you ever saw one of those things, like something like that in real life coming at you, just run for your life.
Knock. It's kind of like my brother a little bit. Like my brother when he was really young. Some these fucking things.
Yeah, those little tadpole shits are the worst. Oh my god, now you got a brother. Thanks, Candy. Useful.
What are you doing?
I don't know. I wasn't gonna say anything. I don't be side-seat gaming.
Brett, what are you doing? What the fuck are you doing?
And we're one key short.
It's like looking around everywhere. Oh my god.
What the fuck? Who? No door, nothing? Sorry, 1989 game, unacceptable. Whoa, what the fuck? Wow, so now I'm dead anyway. Fuck it, I'm just gonna try it without.
You just
I know I'm gonna die, but whatever.
Nice.
I was about to say, like, what, I have to go back through? Alright. Please tell me there's something in here. Oh, do I get to, can I be that guy?
Yeah, I think you can.
Nope. Oh my god, now I'm dead. God damn it, how are you supposed to know? Ah! Not another day!
How are you supposed to know?
Give me everything you got! Everything you got!
What's that from?
From, I Love You, Man. The guy, the workout guy. That's like super high pitch voice.
Oh. Nemo.
Nemo. Finding Nemo. Wonder if Capcom thought about snooing. Well, I can switch out, right? Because I gotta, I'm gonna pick up.
I doubt it, because Nemo is a novel, is it?
I don't know.
What I get hit by on this is, when you go between these two,
Yep.
Okay, fuck well, it. That's one way to do it.
I mean, I have two whole fucking hit points right now, but...
Ooh.
Wow, does nothing. Come on, what the fuck? Wow, dude, that is so fucking annoying. You have to back up in order to get around them, but then as you go back, you respawn them. And now I gotta start all the way the fuck over again.
Yug.
What the fuck, dude? That's just bad design, sorry. Hello? You know, we're gonna get through that wall and there's only gonna be, it's only gonna be the sixth key. Guaranteed.
You think so?
Yep. I just know it, because I know this game, because fuck you, that's why. Out, so I'm like, if I miss this jump, game's getting broken. How am I supposed to get up there? Am I supposed to get to the B?
Can you jump straight up, maybe?
Tell me I fucked it up.
No, you didn't. You didn't. You're fine.
I know there's a
go
B down there.
Go all the way to the right. Maybe you can climb up the
Yeah,
wall.
I'm gonna go all the way to the right. Nope.
Nope. Okay, go down.
I'm gonna have to go down and get the B, I think. What? Oh my god. This is very important to have, by the way. Thank you. It looks like I'm trying, like I'm not trying to hit those things. I'm trying as hard as I can.
Do you think it's worth getting that med kit?
I don't know. I'm afraid to go back. Is the wall back?
No.
I don't know, what do you think?
I think you got it.
I'm gonna go get it, fuck it. I mean, I have no lives left. I mean, worst case scenario, we just do it like, this is how it all, like, this is how it works. Like, one of us figures out what to do, and then the other one's the closer.
Is there more keys down below?
I don't know. I'm going to look. There it is. There's number seven.
Oh, man.
Oh, baby. Ooh, baby, baby. I was like, if I see an eighth keyhole, that's it. This fucking TV is going out the window.
Throne?
Chiclet style.
What is it?
Chiclet style. The commish.
Eat the fucking candy. Think it'll be terrible?
Probably. How many kids played this game and then went outside and found, like, salamanders trying to shove...
Whoa, I just thought of a thing.
What?
You can mid-air change.
What do you mean?
So you could jump up really high and then change back into Nemo.
You could.
I can't really think of where that would come in handy, but...
It's doable. I wanna hear the story about, like, a little kid from the Midwest who found a salamander and played this game and then tried to shove a Milky Way up its ass or in its mouth or something. Because you know that happened, since video games make people do crazy things. Well, you're getting down to the stratosphere again. Oh, man!
Buddy.
I was about to say, if you missed that
jump, I almost blew it.
I know. Yep. See ya. Oh, that's nice. Good job, brother.
Thanks.
I wonder if the people that made this game were, like, parents.
They probably were.
And they dealt with, like, little kids who can't sleep. My kid can't sleep, and he's, like, just 4 months old. And he already is, like, pulling moves to stay awake all the time. Just for my own sake of... Alright, good. I just wanted to make sure I actually did grab that. I couldn't remember if I got it or not. Is there one in the guide that I missed?
I don't know. I'm reading it now.
Alright, cool. Sorry. I didn't mean to... Barking orders. I see it. I see the key.
You do?
Yeah.
Is it like in the beginning or something?
Yep. It's all the way back over here. And it's down here.
Ah. Nice.
Sweet. At least it makes getting through this level way easier because I don't have to do any bullshit.
Do you have to get the mouse, though?
Yeah, I guess I do. God damn it.
Maybe check to see if you have to? I guess you do.
Yeah, I have to. I have to get through that wall. Of course, now I'm gonna die. Because these fucking shit puffs. Yeah, I survived. I don't even care with the AC on, it's still fucking... I'm sweating in here. This is a sweaty game. Wow, how did I do that?
I think you just need to go.
I don't know why I'm so nervous.
Nice.
All right.
topsy-turvy.
Toopsy-toovy. Is there... Do you get... Wow!
Gunning.
Come on, man. What the fuck, dude? That is so fucking cheap. Really? Oh my god, dude. Thank you. Cool. There, you feel better? Jesus. It's fucking so annoying.
You know who kind of did a pretty interesting take on something like this was Adventure Island 3.
That's another game. I need to get the other games in that series. 3 is the really expensive one, right?
Yes. I don't know how much it is now, but it was one of those ones where I had it when I was a kid, and the story behind it was I went to my other cousin's house, and he had... Super Nintendo, and so he had Super Adventure Island.
Ah.
So I told my mom.
Oh my god.
I asked my mom for it for like my birthday or for Christmas, and I guess she either couldn't find it or she got mixed up. And she bought me Adventure Island 3 for NES instead.
Hmm.
And I was bummed because I really wanted to.
I might just kill myself because I can't get through this fucking game. Sorry. No, it's fine. It's just like I don't understand. Like I got through it. I did the best run I've ever done of that. I got through it flawlessly, and then I missed the fucking easiest jump.
Well, it turns out Adventure Island 3 for NES is actually really good, and the Super Nintendo version is good too.
That's the one where you can like pick different dinosaurs to ride on and stuff, right? Yeah, I remember that.
That hurt you, though.
We got fucked on by the fucking puffcocks.
Nailed it. Oh, I gotta go all the way down.
Fuck those things, man. I'm telling you. These things are from hell.
These are the worst enemies in the game.
They are. Like, how is that even possible? Fucking skull with a Q-tip on the end of it. It looks like one of those Japanese ear things. The ear cleaning things?
Yeah.
Kazumi had one, he didn't tell me what it was, so I had it in my hands, and then I was like, what's this puffy ass thing? And he's like, oh, it's for cleaning my ears. I was like, what the fuck?
Did you know that Caucasians have different earwax than...
Really?
Yeah. They have wet wax. And
what's the
Asians
opposite?
Have dry wax.
Yikes.
Fuck me. That thing... Got it. It totally nailed it.
Totally
it was like, all right, I'm going to come in right when he's at
hey,
so he has
the good distraction. We're close, though. I feel like we're really close.
There's another level after this.
Yeah, I know, but I mean, like, crack. This one's the hardest one. That's what the guide said. The next level isn't as hard.
Jesus Christ, how many of these?
That it didn't say. Ugh, that guy's so creepy in the background.
I knew it. Oh my god, how many of these are there?
I don't know, that didn't say. I think you're coming up on the last one.
My hands are so sweaty.
So apparently there's like a thing where you can just stay across the top, and there's a med kit and a 1-up somewhere along here. Of course. There you go. And then, actually go back to where you were. And then fall... It's like fall off this platform here, and there's more one-ups according to the guide. There you go.
Nice.
There's another med kit to the left if you need it.
I mean, I don't think I need it. I'm full.
So,
just fall down?
Yeah. And just head to the right. You're gonna lose the mouse anyway, so you might as well. Alright, last boss. So you want me to tell you what to do?
Yep.
Alright, so... head up the steps and drop down to meet the last boss. He will shoot lasers at you. You just have to dodge the first one and the rest of them will miss. The blob will just follow you around. The guide mentions that sometimes it's good to keep the blob available because he doesn't do anything while the blob is out. Oh, never mind.
That's
so
true.
Well, it's pretty straightforward. Just gotta, if the blob comes out, just kill it. If the laser comes out, dodge the first one, the rest of them should miss you.
Okay.
So, like, in all truth, at this point, if you die, you should continue here.
No.
Shit. That blob's gonna come back. At some point, I think. Yeah.
It's gonna take 15, forever.
You need
15 fully charged.
Yeah,
right?
Or a whole bunch of small ones, rapid ones.
It's like not doing my input. It's really annoying.
It's like me when I got acid reflux. Get that blob in a pretty decent pattern, it's not doing anything.
It jinxed me. Shit, I fucking hesitated. Shouldn't have done it.
Seems to me like rapid shots is just better. I don't know, maybe it's just me. I feel like by the time you line it up, it's like the blob is always there to block it.
Yeah, I think you're right.
I mean, as much as it sucks, I have to hit him like a billion times.
Ah, that was fucked up.
Holy shit, you just beat Little Nemo. I didn't beat shit, you did it. But that was
we beat
banging.
It, we beat it.
Oh, thank Christ, I did not feel like coming back for this. Now you get to talk to Dick Nose McBeard Face.
Man. That was one of them, man. That was one of the ones that broke me down.
Yeah, I was super frustrated by the end of that. Super frustrated. Alright, well, you want to do Final Thoughts real fast?
Yeah.
Alright, I'll go first. So, I don't know, it always happens where, like, we beat a game and then I'm like, oh, it's not that bad. No, like, I think that this game is... It's like two games, basically. It's like, the first half is like a little, like, key-finding, spelunking thing that's kind of cute and okay. And then the last two levels are just, like, fucking straight... just bullshit. Like, they're just so hard and frustrating. Like, even beating the game, like, that's cool and it's really exciting and all, but it's like... the level of cheapness that you experience leading up to that almost takes away from beating the game. That's how bad it is. It's like, it was worse than Kid Dracula, it was worse than Predator, it was like, I don't want to say it was the hardest game, but it was definitely the cheapest one to beat. And I feel like now we've gotten all these like really rad-ass cutscenes. Like, that's it, that's what we get out of it, like, I don't know. I felt like the mechanics of the game are cool at first, and then they wear off real fast, and then what you're left with is a mediocre platformer with some cheapness to it, and one enemy that makes the game fucking miserable for you. And that's really
about
it.
Those fucking cream puff things.
Yeah. It's worth getting. I think it's kind of neat, but it's not a game that I would spend a ton of money on. Like, $8?
Is it worth $9?
Yeah, I'd say it's worth $9. I do $9, because it's beatable. It's just very frustrating. And I think the storyline is cool. I think it's a cool idea. But... oh, that's it. What do you think?
I enjoyed it. I thought it was pretty good. There are some aspects of it that were really cheap and frustrating. I feel like once you get the hang of them, they're not too bad. But by the time you do, you're so worn down. That looks just like Mega Man.
It does.
You're so worn down that you really lose your focus.
Yep.
So it's a test of your patience, really. And, I really did think the last levels were kind of fun.
Except for the blue part.
Yeah, I mean, it was frustrating.
That part drove me nuts.
I feel like if we were fresh, that wouldn't have been such a problem.
True. Very true.
And I guess it's just trying to figure out how to get through the game now. Before this time, I was not able to get past the second level. And so I'm pretty happy that we did it. I think...
yeah, I'm glad that... If you
see this game for $5... I think
it's worth it. I'd say it's worth $9 that price charting has it at. I mean, it's not a terrible game. It's just, the ending's just frustrating, you know? And it was
July 2016, it is, yeah. $9.
It's just the last two levels. It's very reminiscent to me of Kid Dracula, where it's like, the game up until the very end is tolerable, and then the last couple levels just become very frustrating. But it's not like it's impossible, and I do agree. I think like part of the problem is that, you know, we're doing this on a, you know, Tuesday night, and it's 12:30 in the morning. Well, it's Wednesday technically, you know.
Yep, and the controls are pretty good. So there's not really any control issues.
Yeah.
Those, I mean, I thought it was kind of creative how they used those little white things that, by themselves, you can usually dodge, but then they put the pressure on by throwing them at you in the middle of other stuff. And I think they could have expanded on some of the other... I felt like they used the frog a lot, and they used the bee a lot, but you didn't see the hermit crab used that much.
Yeah, you only used that once. The fish you only saw once. The gorilla you only saw once. There should have been more.
Yeah, I mean, maybe they could have done something like Mega Man style, where there's 8 bosses, and you have to use the animal to beat it. And, you know, I thought the last boss was pretty easy. Like, let's say Kid Dracula's last level was way more...
Oh, yeah. I thought the last boss was... I mean, I didn't fight him, but it looked really easy. It just was getting up to it was the part that was so fucking obnoxious.
The last thing that I want to say about this game is, once you understand how the developers thought, it makes a lot of the rest of the parts of the game a little bit easier to understand, because you kind of know where they're going.
Yeah, like key placement is like it got real obvious.
You know where you know what to expect almost, even though you've never been to the level. You know what they're going to do. So,
yeah. Well, that's pretty impressive. We beat Little Nemo, which is a game that not many people, I think, beat. I'm sure a lot of people have beaten it, but not that many people I know. So, yeah, this is Little Nemo, the Dream Master for Retro Wednesdays. Until next time.